This conference will now be recorded.
Are you able to see my screen? Yes. Any questions?
So far, no, but the question will come in next few days.
Okay. Did you get the system access? Are you practicing it?
Yeah, I get the system access. I tried yesterday. The system is pretty good, so it's working.
Okay.
And
okay.
We just try. I'm trying to work on a couple of transaction codes. It's working. So hopefully we're going to start after when you complete the work center, because the things are,
yeah,
the production planning is not still in a full-fledged. Only we did the two master data. So when we go in a full-fledged, then we start from beginning to continue the work, you know.
Okay. Okay. Sure. So yesterday we are discussing on work center.
It didn't start yet because I got the access today.
Okay.
I will start as soon as we finish the work center. Thank you.
Okay.
The work center, we did it only, the costing was left over.
Yeah, correct. So are you able to see my SAP screen?
Yes.
Okay. I am opening. Yesterday we discussed up to scheduling tab. Now I will explain you about the costing tab in work center. So yesterday I saved that work center. So I am opening that in a change mode, CR02. Mm-hmm. Okay. This is the initial screen. Okay, so in initial screen we need to give the plant and work center name and press enter. So now you are able to see this basic data in work center.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So the last tab is costing. This is the integration between PP and costing people. PP and costing. Here we will enter the cost center. Okay. We will enter the cost center details. I'm entering first the cost center. So you can select any cost center from this controlling area. Controlling area is 3001.
Now, is the cost center we have to create, or the cost center will come from the FICO guys?
FICO guys, they will create the cost center.
I see.
We won't create it. This tab, the details which are going to enter here in this tab, all the details should be provided by costing people. They will provide, just we will maintain the values here. Okay,
but the machine and labor is the,
yeah,
is the same, that is going to be pulled from the capacity scheduling or whatever we did it yesterday.
Correct. These two, what are the activities? It came from the, in the basic data we enter the,
mm-hmm,
standard value key.
Mm-hmm.
It will come from the standard value key. Okay, that means whatever we are entering here means automatically it will come from the, in the basic data view, you enter the standard value key, from there it will come. Okay, that means we are calculating the cost for these two activities. in this work center. That is the meaning. Okay.
Okay.
So for mission, to run that mission, per hour, it may be $50. So that cost, you want to get that cost calculated. So we need some settings here to get that cost per hour, $50 for mission, and for labor it is $100. So that calculation will be done from here if you maintain the data here. If you're not maintain, it won't get that cost, and that
okay.
cost will go to this cost center, whatever you maintain.
Where we have to maintain means activity
yeah.
type or
I will tell you that those
okay.
details now. Okay, now so mission, against mission, this activity type we need to maintain. Okay, this value also will be provided by the costing people only. Okay,
okay.
I think there are no costing activities are not there. Sorry,
activity type, the finance team should create it or
correct, they will create this activity type, they will create and give it to us, means it will be there in the F4 list, so we need to select that. Okay, and here one is activity type, then we will enter the unit of activity like ours we will maintain, and then we will enter the formula also, formula like costing and scheduling, how we selected the formula, so same formulas we will select here to calculate that calculation. So for example, mission, we need to select the SAP 002. For labor, you need to select the SAP 003. And activity types and hours, only activity type we don't have this. I will find the transaction code, if possible I will create, let me see, that is finance activity, we don't require to create. No, I could not able to find the transaction code. Okay.
Maybe you can Google it. Sometime I
yeah.
Google it, missing some transaction.
Okay.
I think activity type you can create from the SPR.
Yeah, I have put this now. Activity type mission.
Mm-hmm.
you cannot copy it from any other because no activity type group is needed.
Okay. Now we have some activity types. Activity type.
Okay.
Oh, it is saying in the same controlling area. Okay.
The activities type is supposed to be a same controlling area that will take. Otherwise, it will give you error. You know.
Correct. So I'm just creating with all the data, mission name, mission, accounting unit, hour, cost center category.
All cost centers from the top.
All cost center. Accounting type category. Okay, I'm not sure what is that.
Maybe production.
You must have specific cost element for act cost element. Cost element.
I think why don't you take the activity type from the list and then copy it from copy it with the controlling area.
Let me check. Okay. H star 19007. Oh, chart of accounts is not there. It won't take actually. No. Some other details is also not available. Cost element 9001 is not there. Okay. I am leaving it. I don't want to waste time. Okay. So costing related, some parameters are missing to create this activity type.
We can leave the cost center here when you, after the class, you can create the cost center and then we can do it.
Yeah.
Next time. Then we have to move on for the further step.
Correct. I'm just canceling it. So without this also, we can save the data. No problem.
Right.
Okay. Now I'm going to the work center.
Usually, all this data is dictated by some of the all this.
These will be created by costing and they will give the values. We will maintain that's all. Okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay. So here the with these details, CC1 and everything, we will maintain and we will save it. Okay. And now where you can maintain the price.
I have a question, but you okay.
Yeah, no problem. You can tell me. I'm still again open.
Is the you know the costing says a formula?
Yeah.
SP002 and SP002.
Mm.
Where they take it from? I think you say something, but I'm missing that.
Okay. So these formulas from here you can see you can take the same formulas like scheduling. There you can see the in the formulas you saw that there is a tick mark for costing also. So these formulas can be used for costing as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the same thing you can see formula. You can see if this tick mark costing is allowed, that formula can be used. So, it is like yesterday I explained for one car you need $50.
Mm-hmm.
So for five cars, how much? $250.
So this SP003, that's the formula is reflecting on that, right?
Correct. For labor. This is for labor.
Okay. And for the machines?
It is SAP002.
Okay.
So now, how the system will calculate the cost? Okay, how the system will calculate cost for this one is the costing people, they will maintain the cost per unit, per hour cost. That they will maintain, actually, there is another transaction code KP26. KP26, this is a costing people. Here you can see price planning, activity price planning. For each activity, for mission hour, for 1 hour, $50, that they will maintain here.
So the costing people will do this, right?
Yes, correct. For example, if you want to see, I don't know whether it is maintained or not.
Costing people means it's look like this is FICO job, yeah?
Correct, FICO. This is FICO job. Okay. Cost center does not exist. Oh. This cost center is wrong. F4. Yeah, for example, here they will maintain. Okay, like for 1 hour capacity, like 1 hour, what is the fixed price? Maybe $50. Okay, $50 they will maintain and they will save it. From this system will pick during the cost calculation. Okay, for each activity. So this is also a finance costing people. Okay, is it clear? Work center.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Now I am going to the next master data. That is routing. Routing means, you can see the meaning itself, name itself, routing means route. It is nothing but a path. Routing means route or path, means starting from one point to ending from one point. That is a general meaning. Starting and ending. So in SAP, in production planning, what is the starting means? To manufacture our car, you need to follow certain steps. So all those steps we will maintain in this routing. The steps are like to manufacture a car. First, we need to assemble the tires. Maybe first we need to assemble the engine. Then we need to fix the tires. Then we need to fix the glasses and all electronic devices. So all these we need to fix, assemble one by one. So all those steps we will maintain here in the routing along with its timing. Okay.
So in other words, means man hour, timing,
yeah. Correct.
And material. Okay.
Correct. Okay. I will show you. For example, first we are assembling or fixing engine. So then next we are fixing the tires. The third step we are fixing all electronic devices.
Now other the question I have here, when you are working with routing, okay. Now as you say, first we fixing the engine and tire and then electronic devices. I mean, who will decide this, that who is doing the first job that we create the routing?
Okay, this is the business only, because they will do their work. We are, as SAP consultants, we are just copying the data from them and we are putting in our SAP. The business knows, we are only just, we are the only consultants. We will copy the data, or we will take the data from business and we will put in SAP. But we won't decide which is the first or which is the last. The car manufacturer business, they will decide, because they know their business. We are outsider.
So they will send the email that you can send us a routing for engine, routing for tire or something like this.
Correct. They will already have the data, because they are manufacturing from long time. We are just now we came to implement only SAP system for them. Okay, we will take the data from them and we will enter the values in our routing. Okay, so like this we will enter finally painting. Like this we will enter all these steps. Those are called the operations.
Yeah.
These are called the operations, and each operation wise we need to enter our activities. Activities like what is a machine hour and what is a labor. That means to fix the engine, we may require 1 hour. Labor of maybe 2 labor are working, so each one is working 1 hour, so you need to maintain 2 hours for labor. Tire, maybe it is taking 1 hour, labor is only 1 person is working, so you can maintain that. So each operation wise you need to put the how much is taking the time. Okay, like 2 hours, this is 1 hour. Maybe painting 3 hours, labor is 1 person. 1 person, not 1 person, here 3 hours. Like this you need to maintain in this routing all the operations, and each operation wise how much time it is taking, everything it is required. Okay, based on this one, system will calculate how many days it will take to manufacture a car. For example, in this example, the total machine hours is like 7 hours. Okay, 7 hours is your machine time. So to manufacture one car, system is taking the 7 hours. So if you create a planned order or production order for 5 cars, so system will propose 5 into 7, 35 hours it will take. So 35 hours means maybe a 1.5 day or 2 days. Okay,
yeah.
So your example, your work center, this is working, this work center is working 8 hours per day. 8 hours per day, that means to manufacture 5 cars, how many days it will take?
35 hours.
2 days. Yeah. Less than 5 days. 5 days?
Yeah, very good. So your start date, based on this one, system will calculate start date. Start date, for example, today is the starting. You are starting this production today. Okay. So end date is after 5 days, maybe on 9th. Okay, so system will calculate like this based on the data whatever you are maintaining here. Okay, Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So now I will show you the how to maintain this in SAP now. To create and display and change the transaction codes for routing is CA01, CA02, and CA03. Okay. Now I am opening the transaction codes. You are able to see my SAP screen now?
Yeah.
Okay. So production, here is the folder routings. And I think you are working, Nicholas, you are working in PM module, correct?
No, I am MM and
yeah, you're
SD.
I'm working with PM
module. Ah, okay. Yeah, Jamal, you are working on PM. So this routing is nothing but your in
Tasks.
Your module. Yeah, task list. Okay. Both looks like same only.
Exactly. That's my question that I'm asking you.
Yes.
Why the PM module is a task list and the same thing, same data, and same tab in a table format is in planning. Is a transaction code is a different and the name change.
Yeah. I am not sure why SAP is designed like this. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But they are calling it different names in a different modules. Like
and
your
also,
module, it is a. Yeah.
And also, you know, different T codes.
Transaction codes. Yes, correct. Different transaction codes. I am not sure. Okay. So this is the navigation CA01.
Right.
So here, first we will enter the material. I think you, in your case, you will enter equipment. Equipment or no, nothing?
Well, we can use the equipment because there are three task lists. One is equipment task, function location task list, and general task list.
Okay, okay. But in PP, we will refer only the material.
Only the material, yes.
Yeah, maybe that is the reason they put the different names. But I'm not sure. Okay.
I see.
Okay. So in this initial screen, first we will enter the material. Our material is Honda car. And then plant. Plant is 0001.
Right.
Then press enter. So now here is the header details. Screen will appear first. Then here. First, you need to enter the what is the usage means what purpose. Yeah. We have a specific production is there usage. You can select the production.
Yeah.
If you want to use for all purpose, you can select the universal. Okay. So here you can select the production. One. And overall status. Overall status means whether this routing is in a created state or it is a released status. Released means you already created and all the data is maintained. So now you are ready to use this routing. That is called the release. So always you can select the four release general. So these two details we will enter in this header details. So the next is in the top, you have the buttons like routings, assignment, sequence, operation, and allocation.
Okay.
So here.
One second, please.
Yeah.
There are other fields, which is planning work center that we did the work center. So can is that not the work center that we can enter here?
No, we won't enter the work center here. We will enter in the next step, the work centers.
But what is this work center means, planning work center?
Okay, if we are having only one work center, okay, for some planning purpose of this routing, then we will enter it here. Okay, But if we enter here, we cannot maintain the work center, mission time, labor time, and everything, because there is no option here. Okay, those we will enter in the next step.
I see.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second. That I just trying to copy it in this, please.
Okay.
Planner group is not, no, you don't need it, the planner group or?
No, these are not a mandatory fields.
Okay.
Okay, if you want to use them as a some reporting purpose, you can enter.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead please, next step.
Okay. So next step is click on the operations. Click on this button, operations.
Mm-hmm.
So here, you need to enter all your details.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. First thing is, first column is operation 10, 20, 30, 40. This is nothing but a serial number.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, like that. These are 10, 20, 30, 40.
Mm-hmm.
So the next third column is, you need to enter work center here. So whatever we created work center, WC001, you can enter here. After enter here, if you press the enter button, so here you can see control key. So this will get copied from the work center. We maintain one value.
So this control key is the same control key that we did it in work center, right?
Correct. Okay, when I press enter, it will get copied here. That is one thing. Okay, next here you can see standard value text is there. Text 1, and here it is text 2, everything is there. Okay, so when I press enter, this standard value text is nothing but it will get replaced with, we have maintained the two values, standard values, one is mission and one is labor in this work center. Those will get copied here. These
okay.
Headings will change now.
Yeah, and the other thing is we did not create the activity type. So activity type over here will be empty. So how we can process it?
Correct. It will become as empty only, but there is no issue. Means you don't get any errors here.
Okay. All right.
So now I am just pressing enter. Now you can see control key got copied. PP01, and you can see the text is changed, mission, and this is labor, and unit of measure we maintain is hour. It came here. Okay. So these values got copied from your work center. Okay. Now here, first we need to maintain the description. Operation 10 is like fixing
machine,
mission,
engine,
fixing engine. Okay, and to fix the engine, how much time for to fix one base quantity means one car. Okay, to fix one car, what is hour? Maybe 1 hour. Labor time is 2 hours. Okay, like this, whatever the steps are there, you can maintain all. Okay, and here the first work center.
Present.
Yeah. Okay. So all these steps, whatever we written here, you can copy and paste it directly. And enter the work center details.
Okay. SOP is called sub standard operation or something like this.
Sub operation.
I see.
Sub OP means operation.
Okay.
It is a within the operation, you want a small operation also. You want another sub operation. So you can maintain if you want. Within 10th operation, you want again maintain some sub operation. Like during fixing engine, you are fixing some bolts. You want to maintain that bolts also. Fixing bolts.
I mean, any additional work here.
Yes, correct. those you can maintain as a sub operation. Okay. So
Yeah.
for each operation wise, you can maintain the timings here.
I'm sorry, what did this sub operation mean? Like what exactly?
Yeah. Only additional.
Okay, for example, you can see this is the main operation. You are fixing engine is the main operation. Okay, in this, you will do some small activities like fixing bolts. Okay,
okay.
lifting engine from the outside to near to car. So
yeah.
these operations is a small operations. You want to measure those two, those also, then you can maintain here as a sub operation.
Mr. Vasu, can you bring the screen down? I want to see what is in the bottom of the screen. Any fields there?
No, nothing. No fields. This is just like an Excel. You can enter so many rows, whatever you want to.
I see.
Where do you define SOP? Where you define it in different transaction?
No, here only.
Oh, but it's a gray.
Here only. Yeah, for example, for 10th operation, you want to make as a one sub operation. Here you will enter that main operation number and press enter.
Yeah. No, no.
Okay. Okay. You can enter that operation number and you will enter it here. So operation. Okay, so like this, you can enter the some more details. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Okay. You can see for
okay,
the 10th operation, this is a sub operation, and you can maintain.
Great. Yes, great. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm deleting it. Okay. So is it clear? Whatever we enter here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, now in this thing, very important thing is a control key.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, control key. See, its name is control key, means it is doing some control for this operation. It is doing some control for this operation. So what it is controlling? So if you go to the setting of this PP01 F4 list, you can see here the so many keys are there. PD, PA, PM. I think you are using PM also.
Right.
Okay. So PP related, this is the PM related, but PP related is starting with the PP. If you paste down it, so you will get the PP related this. PP starting with PP is our manufacturing related, like PP 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. Okay, you want to see the details of this one. For example, PP01, select this and in the bottom click on the detailed information. So here for PP01, these are the tick marks are activated. Okay, so that means if you use this control key, these functions will work for this operation. Okay, example. Like here you can see right side, print confirmation, print a time ticket and print. Okay, so these tick marks are related to printing of this operation. When you created a production order, in the production order, these the details of this operation will get printed because you have activated these tick marks. Okay, if these tick marks are not there, it won't print. Okay, the next is in the left side, you can see scheduling. I told you the scheduling means calculation of start date, start and end. Start and end. Okay, for example, if you not tick mark this end, what will happen is you can see you enter the machine hour is 1 hour and lab is 2 hours, total 3 hours. If you did not tick mark this one, system will not consider these 3 hours.
Yes.
It won't consider. Okay. Even you enter the values but system will not consider for production time if you not tick mark this one. And capacity also same. Determine capacity requirement means while calculating its capacity, machine capacity. So that time system will not consider these values if you remove this tick mark. And then cost means I told you each machine or labor you can maintain the cost per hour. If you remove this tick mark is not there. That means it won't consider your cost also for this operation. Okay, so how the system is calculating these functions are based on this control.
Sorry, where is the capacity here? Determine capacity requirement. Where is it here in the writing? I don't see it.
This capacity comes from the work center.
Correct. And here another field is there, automatic GR. This I will explain you later. This is a specific different function actually. Okay, I will explain you this later. And then next is inspection characteristics required. So that means this is the integration point between PP and QM module, quality inspection. Okay, if you want to do inspection for this operation, during this operation, this tick mark should be activated.
Right.
Okay. Otherwise, you cannot do the inspection. Automatic GR actually integrated with MM. So I will explain you that later classes. Okay.
Yeah.
If I explain, it is not good in the flow actually. Okay. I will explain you later. Okay. Next is rework. That means you are doing this operation, find out it is a not a good quality, you need to do rework.
I see.
Cool.
So
that
how
time
it take,
you need
how,
to make
how this will be tick marked when you rework. You will go to change mode in a routing, then it will come automatically, or you will go in a routing to do something that this will be checked.
Okay, this is the configuration setting. We won't change every time. Okay, as per business requirement, we will create a different keys. Like here you can see four keys are there. Okay, set internal processing. Internal processing means here you can see external processing. Okay, so this is not activated. So PP01 is not having external processing.
Right.
So if I select a PP02 details, so this is active, you can see. Okay. And third one is auto GR. Now if I enter, means if you select this one, this tick mark will be there. You can see auto GR is there. Okay. With check, in-house production with check. If you select this one, so it is with the inspection check. So the combinations, as per your combinations, you need to create a different keys. Now PP04 is there, you want with rework, so you will create one more PP05 and you will activate this one. Okay, if the last operation is like rework operation, in that operation you will select that PP05 control key.
So what is a rework? What is this rework?
Rework means, after quality check, you find that product is not in good shape.
Okay.
You need to again, manufacture, or you need to do some modifications. So that is called the rework.
What is PP05?
I have given an example. There is no PP05 now. If you want to create a new key for rework, you can create with the PP05.
I see. But there is no control key for rework.
Yeah. If you want, I will show you now. Okay, I will go to the configuration now and I will show you now how to create this.
I think you can copy any control key and put the PP05.
Correct. Correct.
It will come there and then you select and put over there. So.
Yeah, correct. You can see here SPRY open, expand the production. Production, basic data. In this, in the routing, I'm expanding. Then,
control key.
Yeah, in operation data, you can see define control key. Open this control key. Here, you can see all the control keys are there. For example, you can select the PP01. Click on copy. Yeah. And maintain this as a PP05. And here you change the description like rework. Okay, and click activated. Okay.
Okay.
Activate and you can save it now.
I see.
Save it.
If you not rework check mark, then this key will not be worked.
Correct. You cannot do that operation as rework.
Great. So yeah. And best practice people use PP01 or not?
Correct. Correct. They will use the PP01, PP02.
Yeah.
Okay. So if business want a specific combinations, which is not here, so that time you can create some new control keys, otherwise you can use the standard. Now you can see, yeah, now you can see PP05 is coming. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are the, and here one more thing is external here. Okay, details. Yeah, external processing. Another example is there. What is external processing means? It is a subcontracting. Subcontracting means generally third party. In plant maintenance example, one equipment got damaged. Okay, right. You will call a third party vendor and ask him to repair it.
Because they don't have the skilled worker, so we call the
correct.
Third.
Exactly. Okay, this, that is in a PM module. Like that, in production, one of the step is done by the third party people, like painting. Okay, you don't have the facility to paint it, so you are giving that to third party person. Okay, so that operation, it should be controlled as a external processing.
So that means in this case, the routing, it can have two, three line PP01 and one line maybe PP05 or 6 or whatever, or 3. Is that
correct.
Right?
Correct,
yeah.
Exactly. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so that means in this example last is a painting. Okay, so you are giving this painting to outside vendor. So here you will maintain that external key, like PP02 is the external key. Okay, this PP02 you will select it here.
Oh, external, yeah.
Okay, PP02.
Sorry. This one will, when you run the MRP at the end of the day. And this one will generate subcontract order. Is that right? Maybe.
Correct. Inside this system will generate a purchase requisition.
Purchase requisition and convert it to subcontract.
Correct. You will convert this into purchase order only for this operation. So that means after completion of 30 operation, you will send that part, that car to the third party, this person. He will paint and he will give it to you back. After that, you will do the goods movement. That means final product is ready. Okay. But if you want to enter PP02 now, system will ask you though, who is the vendor, what is the purchase inquiry card number, and all these details. So we are not created. So I am not maintaining that. Okay.
Yeah. Make it easy. Yes.
Yeah. I will. Once you understood the flow, means starting and ending, then all these are the subtopics. If you want, I will explain you how to do that. Okay.
Yes. Agree with you. Yes.
Yeah, that is the reason I'm not deviating much from the flow. Okay, so this is how to create a routing. Is it clear? Any questions?
Yeah, clear. Clear.
Okay. Sure. Once you enter these details, you can save this one, and system will generate. Once you save this one, system will generate one number. That is a routing group number. That is called the routing group number.
Okay.
That internally it creates.
One more thing. When you enter all the data, control key, operation, main hour, and all these things, can you go and click the sent as check or no?
No, not required. If you want to check here, you can see check, but it is not required actually. You can see if you click and check, there is no messages.
I see.
Yes. But that is not a mandatory. If you want to check, you can check.
I see.
Okay. So here, I am just click on save button. So once you click on save button, you can see in the bottom message, routing was saved with the group and this material. So each routing system will generate one internal number that is called the group. Okay.
Yeah, it is this number the top two. Is that right?
Yeah, correct. This automatically comes here because we just saved it. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now this number actually we will use in a next master data. Okay. Okay. Do you have the time to start next master data or you need to leave?
No, I have a class within 3 minutes. After 3 minutes.
Okay. Then. Yeah. Then I will. I will stop the class now. Okay. So we can continue the class on your Monday.
Okay.
By that. By that time, you can start creating your master data. And you can ask any more questions if you get any doubts during master data creation. Okay.
The last time I talked to you that the employer, they are trying to advertising like a master planner and planner buyer and purchase reporting or material manager or demand planner or something like this.
Correct.
And you say you can send me the job description and I will go through this and then we'll
No. I told you can send the job descriptions. Mm-hmm. So based on that, I can give you the what are the topics you need to refer.
Yeah. So then where I have to send you say you're going to give me the email. That's why.
Yeah. I will give you my email ID now. You can note down actually. Okay. My email ID is like sri2123@yahoo.com.
sri2123@yahoo.
Yeah. At yahoo.com.
Okay.
You can drop a mail to this mail ID. So I will check and I will give you some information on that.
I see. Okay.
Thank you. Okay. And our next master data is production version. This is a small master data only. Okay. Mm. After that, we will start our production cycle.
Okay.
Okay. So by that time, you create all the master data.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Jamal, and thank you, Nicholas. Okay. Have a nice day and have a nice weekend. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Bye. Bye. Thank you.
Mohan, are you there?
He's not there, actually.
I see. Who's responsible for the other things, financing or anything?
Financing means?
Means the payment that I was supposed to pay. I lose the
Oh, amount. No, Murli only. Mohan is only the person.
Okay.
I'll ask him to contact you. Okay?
I see. So okay. Murli is the one, right?
Yeah, correct. He's okay. The person.
Okay.
Okay. I will ask him to contact you.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
The email, and I send him also whatever the email he sent me about the money. Okay. I send him money too.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Fine. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye. Yeah. Bye. Bye.